She took the crown when she was only 19.
I am Angela Lee Pucci.
At Atomweight, she is undefeated.
I'm 26 years old.
She is unstoppable.
I am a sister, a daughter, a wife, a mother, a world champion, a fighter, a survivor. This sounds like the start of any other interview that I've given in my past 9 years of being a professional MMA fighter.
Hi, I'm Angela Lee.
I'm Angela Lee.
This is Angela Lee from One Champion.
But it's not. In 2017, I attempted suicide. This is my fight story. As someone who's in the public eye, and especially someone who is a fighter, often the majority of our adversities are kept hidden. We don't want to show weakness, and we feel the need to portray this image that everything is okay, that life is good, that we are strong. And there are truths to that, but what we feel outside of those moments is never acknowledged. Oftentimes, we are left to face those moments alone, dealing with our own self-doubt, negativity, and dark thoughts, along with the silencing fear of speaking our truth to our family. I've always taken pride in trying my best to be 100% authentic and real. But there is a line that only you can draw between how much you choose to share with the world and how much you choose to keep hidden. It is hard to be transparent. It leaves you feeling vulnerable. My car accident on November 6, 2017 was not an accident.
But it's a dream that almost ended when Angela fell asleep while driving back in November.
A single car accident in Mililani that left Lee with a concussion and other injuries.
It was a suicide attempt. For the longest time, I blocked this out of my mind. It's been 6 years, and although I've done a lot of growing and healing since then, it's still difficult to think about, let alone talk about. Because even after my attempt, I was still too afraid to say what I was feeling. So let's go back to 2017.
Her right arm is not completely tied to her
back. I think she's tapped out, she's done it! Into the arms of her father.
Really, really happy to finish with that submission tonight.
I was 19 years old. I was living the dream. 2016, I became a world champion. 2017, I was still undefeated, and I got engaged. Life was good, shouldn't it be? I was getting ready for my fight camp. I was in the middle of it. I was 2 weeks out. I had tunnel vision, and I thought that this fight was the most important thing in my life. I was too afraid of what my family would think and didn't want to let them down. I didn't want to be a disappointment. I couldn't sleep, and I was trying to find ways to harm myself, to take me out of the fight. And when that wasn't working, then I had the idea to get in my car. And the moment I felt my car hit and roll over again and again, in that split second, I experienced a feeling of relief. Not regret, not fear, relief. Because I survived, it was very difficult to go on and live life as normal because no one knew what had really happened. I did tell one person, my husband. And even then, I still felt very alone in dealing with what happened because as much as he loved me and wanted to help me, he just did not understand. And that's not his fault. It is extremely difficult to try and put yourself in someone else's shoes who's mentally unwell if you have never experienced it yourself. I felt fragile, shattered, and I needed to heal and put the pieces back all by myself. I started putting myself back together piece by piece. I started with the smallest things, focusing on my breathing when I felt a panic attack creep up. I'd write a letter to myself, detailing the struggles that I was going through and the things that I was feeling. I'd make a list of 10 things to be grateful for right now. If I was having a bad day and I felt my thoughts and emotions were getting out of control, I would try to do things that I could control. I'd go outside and feel the sun. I'd take a walk, be in nature. My dog Rocky, he was like one of my best friends. When you can't verbally talk about what you're feeling, sometimes just letting your furry friend out and seeing their love can really be comforting and uplifting. I'd make little things instant pick-me-ups, like making myself a good cup of coffee. I let time do most of the work because as the days passed, things slowly got better. This is what worked for me, and it may or may not work for you. The important thing is you find ways and methods that help make you feel better. I am here today so that I can share my story with you. Maybe by hearing this, you can see that this does not have to be the end. There are people who love and care about you. Tomorrow can be a brighter day if you just survive the night. So stay, live to tell your story. In March of 2023, I created Fightstory. Fightstory is a mental health nonprofit organization created by combat athletes for fighters of all walks of life to share their stories, inspire hope, and build a community for all to thrive in their mental and physical wellness journey. We believe stories can save lives.
I know that Victoria is here with us today. I really believe that she's been helping me along the way to create this organization to help people.
Many will ask, why are you choosing to share this now? Why did you create Fightstory?
Sorry.
On December 26, 2022, my sister Victoria took her own life.
At this time, we ask that you all be standing as we observe a moment of silence to remember and to honor Ms. Victoria Lee.
Fightstory was created because of Victoria. She was the most selfless person I knew. She would want her passing to mean something, to save lives. Fightstory is a part of her, just as it is a part of me. It is something we created together to help people and to make the world a better place. We want people to know that though you may feel lonely in your fight with mental health, you are not alone. If you are struggling right now, if you're in a dark place, if you are contemplating ending your life, let us be the ones to say, we understand. How you are feeling on the inside is something that can't be seen by anyone else. But there's a small voice inside of you who knows you may need help. And that's the hardest part, the first step, speaking up. The world is a better place with you here. Hope is real, and you can get through this.